So it's the year 2000. Founder walks into a VC's office and says,
I have an amazing idea.
You know how everyone's on the internet and buying things, right? What we're gonna do is the ultimate fashion e-commerce site. But it's not gonna be a normal site, no. It's gonna be super futuristic and 3D. You're gonna be able to turn left and right like you're right there in the store. And you're gonna have a 3D avatar that looks like you, where you can see the clothes on you before you buy. And that's not it. You're also going to have an AI-powered shopping assistant that helps you buy. And the VC said, shut up and take my money, and wrote him a check for $140 million. They hired the smartest engineers, they planned a huge marketing campaign, and within 1 year, the company was dead. See, what they failed to realize, internet and processing speeds of the year 2000, all of this incredible technology took ages to load. And for those patient, kind-hearted few that waited, they were rewarded with a truly terrible experience and an AI assistant that was anything but intelligent. Now, all of that could have been avoided had they done some prototypes and experiments to validate their idea first. The good news is that this served as a warning, and thankfully this never happened again, and everyone learned their lessons, except that's totally not true, and this is happening continuously till this very day.
To this day!
Why does this keep on happening? Today, we're gonna discuss those reasons and how you can prevent it from happening to you. Everybody knows that there's over 6 million ways for a startup to fail. Many of those reasons are outside the control of the founder.
Changes in the market, competition, technology. The universe just decides to mess with you. We plan to make $3 million in revenue by the end of the third year.
Oh, really?
As a startup founder, every decision you make either increases or decreases your chances of success. And choosing not to validate your prototype significantly decreases your odds of success. It's like shooting yourself in the foot before a race.
Pro tip, don't shoot yourself in the foot.
You probably heard the term MVP, which means minimum viable product. It was popularized by Steve Blank and then by Eric Reiss in his book, The Lean Startup, highly recommended, by the way. Basically, an MVP is the simplest, most usable version with only the core features. Absolutely essential, but even that takes a substantial amount of time and resources. What a lot of founders don't realize is that there's actually a lot of prototypes you can build before the MVP that actually give you a better chance at building a more successful MVP. Think of prototyping like mini startup experiments. Each prototype is meant to test one hypothesis and answer either should we or can we. Should we means the market wants it or doesn't want it, and can we build the technology and product to deliver that value to the market? So the question remains, if this information is out there and it will increase your odds of success, how come everyone doesn't do it?
Two reasons. One involves a cat and the other involves a chicken. Hear me out.
I want to tell you about Schrodinger's cat. It's a quantum mechanics thought experiment that basically says if there's a box and there's a cat in the box and inside the box there's a bit of poison that has a 50% probability of being released or not released, don't ask me why that's the situation, but if that's the situation, that until we open this box, the cat is both alive and dead. And a lot of founders approach releasing their startup into public with this idea. They're trying to push as much as possible into the future that moment of truth where they discover, is the cat alive or dead? Is their startup a good idea or a bad idea? And I've made this mistake myself. And this is not about beefing up your courage to be able to face that moment of truth. It's actually more of an understanding that it's not one moment of truth. It's a sequence of improvements. And the best way to approach this is to add 2 degrees of separation. One, separate yourself from your startup. And two, separate your startup from your product.
Look, we're starting to head into guru territory here, so I'm going to make a sharp left turn and head to reason number two, why startup founders don't validate.
And it is the chicken and egg situation.
You need to hire people to build something to raise funding, but you need funding to hire people to build something.
Understand. If you're not an experienced full stack developer, or if you have minimal resources over time, building these prototypes is not easy.
Well, it used to be not easy.
Using the power of N.A.M.A, for the majority of cases, most people, even non-technical people, can build these prototypes quickly and easily.
I say for the majority of cases because if your startup is in the nuclear fusion niche, maybe don't build wonky prototypes, please. But for web and mobile apps, stay with me.
You know, I totally forgot to introduce myself. My name is Bessel Fatin. I'm a principal startup advocate at AWS for Europe, the Middle East, and Africa. I'm gonna show you exactly how to build each of these prototypes that we discussed using N.A.M.A.
Stick around to find out more.